Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. It's my immense pleasure to welcome you all for the 52nd chartered meeting of MVJC Toastmasters Club. I am Dharani, your sergeant at arms. For the benefit of guests, Toastmasters Club has a mission. The mission of the Toastmasters Club is to provide a positive and supportive learning experience by which members can develop communication and leadership skills. And we have to follow some of the rules at our club. They are, please refrain speaking offensive about the gender, religion, politics at our club, because we do not want to hurt anyone at any chance. And I request everyone to turn on your video so that it will be a very colorful and it looks like a very engaging meeting. And please do not unmute unnecessarily when any speaker is engaging this virtual dais. Introducing to the theme, before that, I would like to say one thing to you all. Heated gold is called ornament, beaded copper is called a wire, and compressed carbon is called a diamond. But heated, beaded, and compressed person is called an engineer. I'm an engineer. And if you are an engineer, please unmute yourself and tell I'm an engineer. Everyone.
I'm an engineer.
I'm an engineer.
I'm an engineer.
That's great. That's great. We are an engineers. And today's theme is Engineers Day, followed by the Moments of Truth session by our Area Director DTM Naveen and Toastmaster Naveen. And this is going to be an amazing meeting. So I'm very eager to start this meeting and to know more about what is this Engineers Day and why it is celebrated. And to without delay, I would like to call a person who will take to this meeting ahead. She is currently in a final year computer science and engineering student. She's currently in eat, sleep, and repeat mode. So I'd like to welcome our presiding officer to start to take this meeting ahead. The virtual stage is yours, Aparichita.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Dharani, for the lovely introduction. A very good evening to everyone present in the meeting. I welcome you all to the 52nd chartered meeting of MVJC Toastmasters Club. For the benefit of the guests and others, Toastmasters is an international organization that aims at improving communication and leadership skills in individuals. And this amazing initiative was started in 1924 by Ralph C. Smedley. So this small initiative that was started in order to help a few people in his neighborhood has now turned into such an amazing organization with so many clubs all around the world. Toastmasters is a really amazing platform that can help you lose the fear of public speaking and learn and develop skills related to leadership. It also provides an amazing judgment-free environment where you can grow and develop and receive feedbacks and be a better version of yourself. So moving forward, I would like to extend a warm welcome to all the guests, all the role takers, and Toastmaster Naveen, who's our area director, and DTM Akshay Kaure, who's our... Now, I would request all of you to please turn on your cameras. This will really encourage the speakers who are coming in front of the camera and speaking. And with this, I finally declare the 52nd meeting of MVJCE Toastmasters Club open. Coming to the theme of the meeting, it is something very special for all of us today, since all of us are engineers, and the theme for today is Engineers Day. Today in 21st century, from cars to aeroplanes, from mobiles to computers, from a single electrical wire to a huge transformer, from a small house to a multi-story building, each and everything that has been built, each and every creation that has been brought out is because of the engineers. Engineers are the most amazing individuals in this world, I believe, because they are the ones because of which we have so much technology. They are the ones who make our lives easier. So Engineers Day is basically observed to mark the birth occasion of Sir M. Vishveshwaraiah. And with this, let's move forward and see what the TMOD has in store for all of us today. The TMOD for today is a first year aerospace engineer. He is a really enthusiastic Toastmasters and he loves traveling all around the world. By traveling all around the world, I mean traveling to various Toastmasters clubs from all around the world. He's already gone to a few Toastmasters clubs from US as well as Germany. With a huge round of applause, please welcome Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Aditya, to introduce us to the team and carry forward the meeting. Over to you, Aditya.
Thank you, presiding officer, for a lovely introduction. Let me share my screen. So, very good evening to everyone present here, dear Toastmasters and guests. So I welcome you all to the 52nd meeting of MEJC Toastmasters Club. So today's theme is Engineers Day, and a happy Engineers Day to all of you. A salute to all the engineers, to all of you. So engineering plays a vital role because it is a way that humans are able to use the rules of the world to achieve things. Mainly these three subjects, that is physics, chemistry, and biology. It teaches us how the universe works. It gives us all the instructions we need as to how things interact. Engineering is a way of taking the instructions and using them to make things and that the nature didn't give us. It is a role of an engineer, however, to minimize the effect of damage on the surroundings of ecosystems and design necessary infrastructures that are both efficient to protect the environment and the people. Engineer aims the benefit of the people present and employing the effective of structures and intended to improve the transportations and living of habitat and of the earth inhabitants. So to begin with our meeting, we have, so I got this quote from, that's where very motivated me that I'm proud to become an engineer. So scientist dreams about the things engineers do them. Scientist investigates which already is, engineers create which has never been. And engineering is an art of directing the great source of power in the nature and for the use and convenience, the convenience of demand. So Engineers Day is celebrated to mark the occasion of the birth anniversary of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya. Sir M. Vishveshwaraya was a visionary, an engineer per excellence, and one of the maker of the modern India. A civil engineer by training, and he supervised the several water management systems. And during his prolific career, like famous Krishna Raja Sagar Dam in Mysore. He is also an innovator in his own right and earned a patent for automatic flue gases. Gases designed to increase the capacity of the reservoir. So the two main objective of an engineer is to be an application of science and analysis of evaluation. So today's Toastmasters meeting has two segments. That is, one is the prepared speeches and the evaluation segment, followed by the moment of truth. So to conduct the evaluation segment, we have our general evaluator. He is a freshly graduated student of MEJC MEJ College of Engineering, and he's an engineer by day and a philosopher or a historian by night. So I would like to call our general evaluator, Toastmaster Aitasam. Over to you, Toastmaster Aitasam.
Thank you, Toastmaster. I'm sorry, guys. I won't be able to talk. But a very warm welcome to everyone. I'm the general evaluator for today. And just like a key aim of any engineer is to upgrade his or her gadgets. And what allows for that upgradation is the various feedbacks to present. So similarly, in the Toastmasters, we have the evaluation, which acts like that feedback. And as any loop, any feedback loop, we have, I have a certain components, certain members in my team which will help me provide the overall feedback. Two of them are individual evaluators for each of the speakers, which we will hear from later on. The remaining three forms what we call the tag team. Tag team. T stands for timer. And the timer for today is the VP education of our girl. She is a third year CSE student who loves to read. And her last dream, If Tomorrow Comes by Shetty Sheldon, left her wanting to be a porn artist. Please welcome Toastmaster Laura.
Hello everybody, I am the timer in today's meeting. The role of a timer in a Toastmasters meeting is to take note of the time and duration of speeches and other role takers. Since we will be having two speeches today and no table topic session, the timing for these speeches will be 5 to 7 minutes. At the beginning of 5 minutes, my background color will change to green, at 6 minutes to yellow, and at 7 minutes to red. And I will be presenting the time taken by each speaker when called upon by the general evaluator during the evaluation session. Thank you, and back to you, general evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Now, the A in the tag team stands for Power of Love. Now, she is the sergeant at arms of this club. She is also a CSE student who loves to play chess and is trying to be as busy as possible. So please welcome Toastmaster.
Okay. Once again, good evening, Toastmasters. I am Dharani. I am your accounter for today's meeting. So as an accounter, it's my role. My role is to take note of all your unnecessary pauses. We call as CRPF, which means C stands for crutch words, R stands for repetitive words, F stands for filler words, and T stands for pauses. For example, crutch words are obviously, you know, literally, actually, basically. These are the crutch words, and repetitive words are like, I mean, I, you mean, and the filler words are, so the pauses are unnecessary pause in between the sentence. This CRPF will be noted by me, and I will present my report at the end when general evaluator called upon. So for your benefit, please take a pause when you think you are using this CRPF. Please take a pause and you can continue with your sentence. And I will be back with my report at the end when general evaluator called upon. So back to you, general evaluator.
Thank you,
Mr.
Now the last member of my tag team, the main. So she describes herself as someone who aspired to fly planes, but destiny had something else for her. She meddled with wires and ICs to become an EC engineer. And of course, she likes to eat and sleep. Everyone, please welcome this message.
Hi, everyone. My name is
Sanjana
Singh. Grammar is structural foundation of our ability to express ourselves. The more we are aware of how it works, the more we can monitor the meaning and effectiveness of the way we and others use the language. It can help foster precision, detect ambiguity, and exploit the richness of expression available in English. My role as grammarian is to make a keen notice of all the good usages and the incorrect usages during the course of the meeting. And also, my responsibility as a grammarian is to introduce the word of the day and the phrase of the day. The word of the day is pioneer. Develop or be the first to use or apply. Example for this is, he was the pioneer of the British canoeing. I encourage everyone to use the word of the day as much as possible. The phrase for today's meeting is to put one's thinking cap. To think very seriously or very hard about something. Example, I have no idea what my speech is going to be about. I'll put on my thinking cap and get back to you about it. I encourage everyone to try and incorporate the word of the day and phrase of the day in today's meeting. I'll be posting the word of the day and phrase of the day in the chat as well. I encourage everyone to use it as much as possible to improve your vocabulary. That's all from my side. Over to you, Toastmaster Alpesan.
Thank you, Toastmaster. As we have already met the timer, our content creates the meeting. I, them, and the whole of my team will add back at the end of the meeting and will give you the feedback that will help you grow. So that is it from my side. Back to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, General Evaluator Toastmaster Aitasa. So now let us begin our first segment. Our first segment is the prepared speeches. A prepared speeches is where the speaker prepares their speeches based on the objective given by Toastmasters International. So our first before moving to our first speaker, let us call our evaluator one, Toastmaster Preeti, to read out the speech objective of Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari. Over to you, Toastmaster Preeti.
Thank you very much, Toastmasters of the day, TM Aditya, for this this opportunity. So a very good evening, everyone present here at MBJ TMC, Toastmasters Club, and the guests joining today. I'm so glad that I'm here. What I couldn't do, you have done it. And you know what? You passed the engineering entrance and joined an engineering college. I tried twice. And of course, the result was so. Congratulations for all the work, hard work you have done, and a very happy Engineers Day to you. Thank God I didn't go into depression. Yeah, that was a passion of my life. So, very warm welcome, my target speaker, Uma Maheshwari. Feedback is a very important part of each of us, our lives, and why. Because feedbacks show us the other side of us, the side we don't know. So my speaker today is attempting her L1 P2 speech 2, right? The main purpose of the speech is for the member to demonstrate that she has applied the feedback received from her first speech. Today, I'll be evaluating the speaker on the basis of the previous evaluation. And at the same time, the basics, the verbal and the non-verbal communication. I'll be giving the feedback at the end of this and all the very best, Uma Maheshwari. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Preeti. Now, our first speaker, she is a passionate and enthusiastic kindergarten teacher nearly for 2 decades, always trying new recipes. She's a proud mother of 2 boys, likes to spend a quality time with her family. Let's welcome Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari. Speech title, Fortitude is an altitude to succeed. So Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari, Fortitude is an altitude to succeed. Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari. Over to you, Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari.
Thank you, Tia Modi. For the lovely introduction. Thank you, dear fellow Toastmasters. There was a man who made living selling balloons. He had all colors of balloons, red, yellow, and blue. He would release a helium-filled balloon into the air. When the children saw it goes up, approach him and buy a balloon. One day, he felt someone tugging at his jacket. He turned around, saw a little boy who asked him, "If you release a black balloon, would that also fly?" The balloon man replied, "It's not the color of the balloon. It is what is inside that makes it go up." The same thing applies to our lives too. The thing inside of us that makes us go up is our attitude. Have you ever wondered why some individuals or organizations or countries are more successful than others? It's not a secret. These people simply think and act effectively and are pioneers in development. I believe that the success of an individual or organization or country depends on the quality of their people. I realized it when I visited Dubai. I was under the impression that Dubai is a desert, nothing will grow there. But when I reached Dubai, I could see many trees and varieties of flower plants. Every day, we used to go out and had a new experience. Once we planned to go to Miracle Garden, we need to travel by metro. Metro station is far from my place. There was a minibus that would take us to metro station. While entering the bus, we have to swipe our metro card and we will get a beep sound. I also swiped, really, I also swiped and got the beep sound. But in metro station, the ticket collector checked all the cards. He found that I have not swiped. I was shocked and panicked and tried to explain, but he didn't listen to me. Then I realized it was the beep sound of the previous person's card. He gave the fine receipt. It was mentioned there, 200 dirhams fine. And I heard about many fees. Now, a new one which I got to know is knowledge fee, 20 dirhams. I was curious, what is this knowledge fee? He explained, a percentage of fine will be used for education, innovation, and future development of the country. By paying these 20 dirhams, you got the knowledge of following the rules of a country. Though it's a lifetime lesson for me, I like the right attitude of the ticket collector. In Miracle Garden, there are umpteen varieties of flowers. For a moment, I thought I have entered a valley of flowers. I preferred the capture of beauty with the camera of my eyes. I observed the moment completely. How is this possible in a desert? I heard the voice behind me. I turned back. A young girl requesting an old man not to smoke there. The old man didn't even bother about her request. A man who wore all these things came near, politely removed the cigarette from his mouth, with his bare hands put it off, threw it into the dustbin, and said, kids and elderly people are around, and they have come here to enjoy the beauty of flowers. So do not spoil the atmosphere. The girl and the man both are responsible localites. I could see the good attitude in them. When we returned home, we were all so tired. We came on a metro. All of us got seat. There was an expat sitting opposite us. At the next station, a localite boarded the train and saw the expat sitting in the lady's seat and asked him to get it. The expat told him, no woman is standing. This seat was empty, so I sat down. What's wrong with it? Even there is no woman, men should not sit there. That's the rule, the localite said firmly. The person got up from the place and apologized. In a trembling voice, asked, are you police? The localite smiled at him and said, no, I'm a localite and a passenger like you. I was stunned. The people are enlightened and honor the rules laid out with great sincerity. In Dubai frame, there were pictures of old Dubai, present Dubai, and the future Dubai in the year 2035. A car driver said, ma'am, if you visit 2035 Dubai, you cannot go for desert safari because there won't be desert. Wow. People everywhere having the right attitude and want the country to go to the next level. Hats off to people of Dubai. Hats off to the king. There is a song in Tamil. Enna thavam seidhanai Yeshoda. Enna thavam seidhanai. What kind of a penance did Yeshoda do to have Krishna as her son? Like that, the meaning of the song. This is the meaning of the song. Like that, even the king of Dubai has blessed to have such a wonderful people. Indeed, the country in all is highly disciplined, beautiful, and organized. We Indians also have to have the same sort of attitude towards our country. Fortitude is an attitude to succeed. Thanks for patient listening. Over to you, Dev Modi. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari. Your speech was very wonderful that you had given a virtual tour for Dubai. So let us move to the second speaker. Before calling our second speaker, I would like to call our evaluator to Toastmaster Aparajita to read out the speech objective of speaker.
Good evening, everyone, once again. My target speaker is attempting level 2 project 1. The purpose of this project is for the member to identify his or her leadership style. The purpose of this speech is also to share some aspect of his or her journey in leadership styles or discuss leadership styles in general. Timer, please note the time limit for this speech is 5 to 7 minutes. All the best to my target speaker. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Aparajita. Our second speaker, he didn't choose to be an engineer, to do engineering in his life, but engineering life chose him. Our speaker is Toastmaster Vishal. So speech title is Control, Toastmaster Vishal, Control, Control, Toastmaster Vishal. Over to you, Toastmaster Vishal.
I remember back in high school, I was the head delegate of our school's Model United Nations Society. So it was my responsibility to go around, find people to take to the conference, and then take them to the conference. Now, the biggest challenge with this, being the head delegate, was not finding those people. It was very easy to go up to people and say, hey, you want to bunk classes for 2 days? And they'd be like, of course I do. So it was very easy to bring people. But the problem arised when people realized what the work they had to do was at these conferences. They had to go research, write down in a paper all their points, send that paper, then go to the conference, and then give speeches and debate, and then form another document there. So they would often back out. They would come to me and say, Vishal, we don't want to go to this conference you call us on. And I would have to explain to them, well, you already told us you're going to come. And then we would have this argument, and half the time they'd leave and half the time they'd stick on and come. Now, if I were to go to Google to get me out of my predicament of bringing people to this conference, and I would type, what are the 5 best leadership styles to help me with this situation? Google would then give me the 5 best leadership styles. But then if you scroll down, it would also give you the 7 best leadership styles and the 15 best leadership styles and how to be the best leader, which is a WikiHow article involving eating more walnuts. So it's not entirely that helpful to go to Google, but from being part of the student council to being the head delegate, with my very sophisticated learning mechanism of failing some more, with the side of failing and an extra dose of more failing, I realized you can broadly categorize leadership into 3 different categories. The first one is giving your subordinates no control, which would be the equivalent of me going to these people who said they'd come to the conference and telling them, if you don't come, we will write you a diary note and your parents will scold you. That would be giving them 0 control over the situation. They would be forced to come because they don't want to get scolded by their parents. The second leadership style is giving your subordinates the illusion of control, which would be the equivalent of telling them, if you don't go, Shirley ma'am will cut 5 marks from your paper, which it gives them the control of going to the conference or choosing between going to the conference or losing 5 marks. Here, they get the control or get the illusion of control because they don't have to go to their parents or they don't have to be afraid of their teacher. The choice is theirs, but the choices are very bad. And the third one, to use it properly, you really have to put your thinking caps on. And the third one is actually giving them control. So what do I mean by that? What I started to do later on, like towards the year as a head delegate, was understand where or why they want to back out. Most of the time, it's not because they don't want to do it. It's because they don't know how to do it or they're not confident to do it. Simply explaining to them and sitting with them and teaching them how to do the things that they need to do at the conference is enough to bring them. Paired with telling them, if you come, I'll convince your friends to come and together you can go. Those two things together give them the choice between either sitting in class all day or going out with their friends and doing something useful. In this case, you've actually given them the control as a leader. And this is often the most ideal situation to be in as a leader. To better illustrate this point about giving your subordinates the control as a leader, I can explain to you the concept of commander's intent. During war, it is impossible for a commander to understand what the situation of the battlefield will be on the day they want to execute whatever plan they have. So they have this concept of commander's intent, where the commander does not give them the exact minute-to-minute strategy of execution for the soldiers. Instead, the commander explains to the soldier what it is the objective of them being there is, and they give them all the tools necessary to execute said plan of action. And then it comes down to the soldier's critical thinking and problem solving abilities on the day of execution to achieve the target. It is on them to figure out any sort of discrepancies in the plan that arise, any sort of altercations that arise. It's up to them to properly work together as a team and come to the goal. But it is because the commanders were able to clearly lay out what it is they want from the soldiers and what it is they want them to achieve on said day, that they're able to bring the best out of their soldiers. And when I look at what kind of leadership style I want to adopt going forward for any teams I might lead or any leaders I might be under, it is that give your subordinates a goal and not a specific minute-to-minute plan of action. Because if you allow people to have that creativity, to allow people to put their own ideas into what they're doing to achieve your goal, they might even bring out a better sort of experience or better end product than you even could have imagined. So thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vishal, for your speech. So now we have completed our first segment, that is prepared speeches. So first objective of an engineer is an application of science. So now second objective of an engineer is an analyzing or evaluation. So let us call our general evaluator, Toastmaster Itasam, to conduct evaluation segment. Over to you, Toastmaster Itasam.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone, once again. So we are done with the first segment, and that's the only segment. So let's first start with the evaluation of the speakers itself, and then we'll move on to the other speakers. So to evaluate the first speaker, I would like to call upon Toastmaster Kiki. She describes herself, she is a neuro-linguistic program practitioner and coach and a certified thought leader and healer. She conducts workshops for students, parents, and executive professionals. She loves art in every form. She is a dancer at heart, an avid reader, learner for life, and a grateful person. Her blood group is A positive, which keeps her B positive in every situation. Please welcome Toastmaster Vinita.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Hi, I believe Lavanya is the timer today.
Yes.
Yeah. Can someone pin her along with me? Thank you very much. Yeah. So a special shout out to my speaker, Toastmaster Usha Maheshwari. It was a wonderful speech today. There is no way better than telling a personal story, a tour, and what you did. You have taken us to a very sensory rich, honest tour of Miracle Gardens, Metro Ride,
You have told us about the morale and the strong discipline the people of Dubai holds, the ownership, the pride for their country, their rules, and the dream, future dreams. It was just wonderful. Your speech was very fluent. It was without an interruption. Every word you spoke, you were confident with a lots of control in your words and thoughts because you have experienced it firsthand. And it was a very clear and smooth flow. What I also liked was, like all the people in the audience, all these budding Toastmasters here were engrossed in your story. They were listening like a childlike curiosity, as if the mama is telling a lullaby to a young child. You captured their attention very well. Kudos to you on that point. There are just a few more things I would like to appreciate. When you were telling about the beep sound, the swipe, and you were shocked, panicked, your facial expressions, your body language, your hand movements, your pitch, your pace was perfect. It was matching so beautiful. You are a natural storyteller. And at the same time, you are blessed with a beautiful voice. I must say, you have a blessed voice. You're a marvelous singer. A few pointers from my side, a small one, just a suggestion. I would have appreciated if you could have shared the evaluation sheet for L1 P2 speech 2 along with your previous evaluation sheet. Not a big deal, I could do that. Secondly, there were little bit here and there, the pronunciation just need to work a little bit more, like yellow and expat instead of expat. And like that, small ones where the little regional accent is there. At the same time, to give us that feeling of offline Toastmasters meetings, which we really miss, it would have been a great gesture. You could have just stood and given the speech. Never mind, that's a personal choice, but that's just a suggestion. At the same time, at the end, I felt I was waiting for something more powerful, some call of action, you know, some powerful conclusion for us to take home. The kind of message you were trying to give, you could have concluded in some powerful ways so that we could have carried it with us. Overall, great storyteller, superb vocal quality, and the pitch, the pace, just awesome facial expressions. And wonderful one. Great job. Kudos to you, Toastmaster Suma Maheshwari. Very well done. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. Yes.
Thank you, Toastmaster. I'll come to the evaluation later on. Let's move on to the second speaker first. So, to evaluate the second speaker, I'd like to call upon this evaluator. We have already met her. She's the president of our club and a fellow Marvel fan. She's a Potterhead who likes Korean dramas, and her favorite are Hotel Del Luna and Crash Landing. Please welcome Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Etisam, for the introduction. Toastmaster Vishal, what an amazing speech. First of all, I would like to, like everyone, to applaud him for the amazing speech that he gave. Starting with the evaluation of your speech, you started with telling all of us about your leadership position that you had. You also told us what led you to Google up these leadership styles. So that was a very good start, I believe, because you told us how you went into that leadership position and why you thought of Googling up this and understanding the leadership styles. You also mentioned three styles, which I think were very creative. The way you presented all of them were very nice and easy to understand. You also gave us a lot of real-life examples, which made it easier for us to relate with these leadership styles that you gave. You had a nice voice control throughout the entire speech. There were little ups and downs, which I felt were quite nice and fitted the entire speech very well. You also mentioned the commander's impact by giving the commander's example. And I thought that was an amazing conclusion to the three styles that you mentioned. And in the closing, you mentioned, why this commando style can be suitable for people. And I believe that the thing that you mentioned really suited you well. So that is one amazing thing. Your energy throughout the speech was quite nice. It wasn't low or it wasn't very high at different points. It was very constant and a very amazing level of energy, I believe. You also portrayed the two people conversation. So in that you turned this side and that side to show that two people were actually talking. So that was one very creative thing I found out. You also had a very, you were very clear in telling us what your actual thoughts were, very clear and very easy to understand. So kudos to you on that. A few points of improvement that I would like to give you is, if you could tell us more about your experience of being in a leadership position, you could have also added a little bit more about you being the head of society, and probably towards the end, if you could have told us how these leadership styles that you mentioned influenced you to become a better leader. Also, if you could have mentioned a little bit about Toastmasters, about your leadership position as a VP at VP membership in Toastmasters, that would have been a little nice touch. And one more suggestion that I would like to give you is, when you did the ending, it was a little abrupt, like you just said so and then took a small pause and you said thank you. Maybe if you could have added a tiny quote, it would have been really nice to end the speech. Overall, amazing speech and congratulations on finishing L2B even. Thank you so much, and over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you so much for the presentation. We'll move to tag name and I'll present my report after that. So then we'll move from the grammarian and we'll come back to the timer. So I request Toastmaster Divya to present the report.
Thank you, Toastmaster Aitasam. I'll be presenting my screen. My screen is visible.
Yes, Toastmaster.
Reward of the day, Pioneer, was used once by Toastmaster Umameshwari. I didn't find anyone using the phrase today. Coming to the good usage, umpteen varieties of flowers, stunt, penance, 42 is attitude to succeed. Toastmaster Umameshwari, delicate, sophisticated, illustrate, and commander. That was used by Toastmaster Vishal. Shout out, morale, lots of control over words and thoughts. Marvelous. Toastmaster Preeti, portrayed and influenced by Toastmaster Prasad. Some of the incorrect usages, like where who takes to the meeting ahead, it can be said like who takes the meeting forward. Called upon can be said as calls. Time and duration. Duration is certainly a more physical concept than time. I think they're not, cannot say it together. Any one of them we can use it. Did the ending? Maybe it came to the ending. These were the note what I made note of today in today's meeting. Over to you, Toastmaster Anderson.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vipya. Now moving on, I would like to call upon Toastmaster Dharani to present the report.
Hello everyone. So I'm back with my report. I will share my screen. You'll get an idea of how many CRPFs you have been used. Is my screen visible? Can someone let me know?
Yes, it's visible.
Okay. So this is my report. And we had two pauses by evaluator two, Toastmaster Aparijita, where she was telling about a you and she gave a pause and she continued with her sentence. And by grammarian, Toastmaster Divya, one pause in between the I and the encourage. And there are lots of R's used by our members. And most of them was used by Toastmaster Aparijita 8 times. And repeat all by Toastmaster Aparijita, who like you also are the more times repeat, and by Toastmaster of the day, Aditya, it is the repeat, General Evaluator So, Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari for, Toastmaster Vishal how to be, Toastmaster Priti is to like. These are the repeats given by the speakers. So I request you to be, whenever you are repeating something, take a pause. That means it will help a lot for you instead of repeating the same thing. So this is my report. Back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Thank you for that wonderful report. Now, can I have Toastmaster presented by Ms.
Thank you, General Evaluator. Presenting the timer's report for today's meeting. Speaker 1, Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari, spoke for 6 minutes and 9 seconds. Speaker 2, Toastmaster Vishal, spoke for 5 minutes and 46 seconds. And both the speakers qualify because Speaker 1, Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari, took 9 seconds over the actual time limit. On to the evaluators. Evaluator 1, Toastmaster Preeti, took 23 seconds. And Evaluator 2, Toastmaster Prajita, took 3 minutes and 16 seconds. Thank you. And that was the report for today. Back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster. Now, let's start my report. I'm sorry if this is from my side. This is something going on here. But let me start my report. The meeting started 2 minutes after a 2 minute delay. And the reason was because not all the members and road takers are present. So I would encourage all the road takers and the members to be present at the right time. One of the things that I have noticed for this, not just this meeting, but all of our meeting, is that we need more members to join. So this is something that I would like to suggest to the XCOM team, work on it. Because if the members don't join, then the guests won't join with the same enthusiasm. Now, coming to SAA, the Sergeant at Arms, we did an audio video check on time. She started with explaining the rules correctly, and she did give everyone a warm welcome. One suggestion for her is that I request her to do the networking before the beginning of the meetings. I observed that there was a very long pause after the AV check to the meeting getting started. There were 6 members present in the meeting, but none of them were speaking to each other. So I request SAA to take the control and do the networking part. Coming to the president of the club, Toastmaster Prajita, she explained the Toastmasters and the essence of Toastmaster very well. She had an energetic start, and I don't have any other specific suggestions for her. As for the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Aditya, and the theme collectively, the theme was very much within the realm of grasping. For instance, it was not something alien to all of us. We are all engineers, and hence it was within the grasp of each and every one of us. And because it was a recent event, the Engineers Day, it made sense why we went with this theme. Toastmaster Aditya knew about the theme and he gave a nice introduction, and everything was planned perfectly. One suggestion for not only Toastmaster Aditya but whoever takes some TMOD is that if you're going with themes such as Engineers Day, you could add a personal touch to it, because we are all engineers. So I was expecting some personal individual experiences or something, but that was missing. So I would request him and the future Toastmaster of the day to take care of it. Another thing for Toastmaster Aditya is that he forgot the voting forms. They are in the link for the speakers to vote them. Now, coming to my tag team, timer of the day, Lavanya, Toastmaster Lavanya, she joined late and she had her reasons. So I would request her, because she is also the lead education of our club, to have a backup timer ready just in case for all these things. Not just backup timer, but backup tag team fuel. And apart from that, she knew her role well, and she did her job well. She stated who all qualified, who didn't qualify. So kudos to you for that. Coming to her counter, she was well aware of her role, Toastmaster Dharani, and she explained the CRPS. She also gave a hint or she also gave a way for the speakers to help themselves. A suggestion for her or any other future her counters is when you're presenting the report, the person knows that he or she has spoken a lot of hours or months. So I would request the accountants to directly cut to the chase and state where and what went wrong. Instead of reading like XYZ has spoken these many hours, just directly cut to the chase and tell where we went wrong, as in you can give us the whole number. As for the grammarian of the day, Toastmaster Divya, she also knew her role well. She even selected the word of the day, phrase of the day that were related to the theme. We could have used a lot of lot more than what we use actually did. One more suggestion, a suggestion for her would be to listen a bit more carefully, because phrase of the day, if I am not wrong, was used by Toastmaster Vishal during the speech. And kudos to Toastmaster Vishal for including phrase of the day in his speech, because that shows his awareness of the meeting. And before coming to the evaluators, I would like to comment in general with the and combine my evaluation of the evaluators and the meeting together. So before coming to the evaluators part, for the meetings, guest welcomes, that was pretty awesome. Agenda was released and the poster was released, that was very awesome. Suggestions for the secretary who's making the agenda is, if there are any changes, please make those changes. And when you're releasing the agenda in the meeting, please make sure that the changes are there. Changes were made after the agenda was published. So when you're releasing the agenda in the meeting, please look at those changes. Apart from that, I don't have any other suggestions for them. Coming to the evaluators, you both, Toastmaster Preeti and Aprajita, did a fantastic job of evaluating your respective speakers. I don't have anything else to add or remove from them. I had one question for speaker one, Toastmaster Puma. Is Toastmaster Preeti the one who evaluated you for L1, P2-1? If Toastmaster Preeti or Toastmaster Puma, if anyone of you can answer.
I'm sorry, I'm not able to hear your voice.
Okay, my question is, did Toastmaster Preeti evaluated you for your previous speech as well?
No.
Okay, fine. So this is something that this is my observation for all of the persons who are attending L1 P22. When you are attending L1 P22, try to have the same evaluator, because he or she knows what he or she is looking for, because it is the application of the previous feedback. So for Toastmaster Preeti, it would be like she has read what is there in your previous feedback, but she doesn't know to what level the evaluator is expecting you to perform. So this is something for all of the person who are taking L1 P2. Coming to, again, specifically for evaluators 1 and evaluator 2, you both did a fantastic job. I don't have anything else to add. You both were cherry on tops on your own reports. I do have a suggestion for both of you, is that when you are introducing or when you are explaining the speech objectives, please specify what are the things you are looking for when you are evaluating. In that way, the audience will also be involved in the speaker's speech more. For instance, if I am looking for hand gestures in someone's speech, so if I say that, okay, Toastmaster XYZ, I am looking for the hand, I will specifically be looking for your hand gestures in your speech, then the speaker himself will be aware, okay, I have to perform hand gestures then. So this is something that I would like to suggest both the evaluators and the future evaluators. Now, overall, till now, it's a great meeting, though, as I said, everything was well and everything was structured well. Toastmaster today handled the meetings well, and even when I look at the time, we are on time with regards to the agenda. So kudos to everyone. Pat yourself on the back, and that is it from my side. Back to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you,
Thank you.
Thank you, General Evaluator. A voting link for the best speaker has been posted in a Zoom chat. Do vote for your best speaker. And now I would like to conclude by saying that engineering is not just a study, it's an art, it's a passion. So I'm proud to be an engineer, and as well as everyone proud to be an engineer. So I will hand over the stage to our presiding officer, Toastmaster Aprajita. Thank you to all.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Aditya. The link for the voting form has not been dropped yet. SA, could you please drop the link? Yeah, thank you. We'll just take 2 minutes to vote and we'll then get back. If you're done voting, it will be great if you use those emojis and put a thumbs up so that I know that everybody is done voting. Okay, meanwhile the others are voting, I would like to ask our guest roll takers about how their experience today in the meeting was. Let's start with Toastmaster Ruma Maheshwari. Toastmaster Ruma, could you please unmute yourself and share your experience with all of us?
Yes, ma'am. Really a wonderful experience I've got here. And I want to appreciate the grammarian. She has posted the word of the day, the previous day itself, and also the... And the takeaway is the phrase of the day. I will advise my club members to adopt the same thing. Thank you. That's it. Thank you, Priti ma'am.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ruma. Next, I would like to ask Toastmaster Priti. So, Toastmaster Priti, could you please share your experience with us?
Wonderful. I was out of the world and I had to wear the thinking cap finally. What to say at the end? I was simply glad because it's a group of engineers and we are celebrating Engineers Day today. Kudos to you and all the very best for your future meetings. Keep it up. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Preeti. We also have DTM Akshay. DTM Akshay, if you could unmute yourself and tell us or share feedback for the meeting with all of us, it will be great.
Hey all, good evening. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Excellent. So great to see that even though we have an MOT lined up today, we still had 2 speeches. So a great job done by the VP Education. Can we all give a round of applause for the VPA? And especially it's very difficult in these days when you know people are tired with all these online meetings that we still have 16 members as I see right now in the meeting. So a great job done by all of you to you know be here, and I would like all of you to stay here for another half an hour or so that we can conduct the MOT with the full heart and soul of the club.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Akshay. I believe everybody has done voting. SA, do we have the results ready?
Yes, the results are ready.
Okay.
Before that, can we take a picture?
Yeah, sure. Let's just go forward and take a picture and then we can have the results. I would request everyone to please turn on your cameras for just a few seconds so that we all can take a picture. Toastmaster Deepika, Toastmaster Shruti, Toastmaster Pradyumna, Toastmaster Lavanya, Toastmaster Akshay, if that's possible. Toastmaster Lavanya, Deepika, Pradyumna, Shruti. Or if you cannot turn on your video as of now, just use those emojis and put a heart emoji or any other emoji that you want. And let's all take a picture. I'll take a picture in 3, 2, 1. Again, with our usual M. Yeah, thank you so much. So the M is one thing that we do always. M stands for MVJC Toastmasters Club. And I hope the results are ready now. Toastmaster Dharani, can we have them?
Yes.
Okay.
So first, let me go with the speaker. Today, winner of the speaker segment is Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari with the rating 4.36. Congratulations, Toastmaster Uma Maheshwari. And the runner-up, Toastmaster Vishal with 4.27. And even congratulations for Toastmaster Vishal. There is a minor gap between both of you. And coming to the tag team, timer Lavanya with 4.1 ratings out of 5. And Divya with the 4.1. And timer Dharani with 4.2. And the winner of the tag team is 4.2 timer. I mean, our counter, Dharani. And coming to the evaluator, we have a tie between the evaluators. Oh, I'm so sorry. No, not a tie. I'm so sorry. The runner-up with the ratings of 4 out of 5, Toastmaster Aparijita. And our winner is Toastmaster Preeti, evaluator 1, with a ratings of 4.7. Congratulations, Toastmaster Preeti, for getting this winner of this evaluator. Coming to the role takers. Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Aditya, ended up with a rating 4 out of 5. And our general evaluator, Toastmaster Atism, got 4.4 out of 5. And our winner for the role taker is our general evaluator, Toastmaster Atism, with 4.5. Congratulations, Toastmaster Atism. And meeting grade has got to 8.5 out of 10. So we can do it better, from still more to achieve out of 10, at least a 9.5 coming up meetings, and we don't have any feedbacks or suggestions. So I think we can go with this thing and we can achieve 9.5 ratings for the meeting. So this is the result. Over to you, presiding officer.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Dharani. Congratulations to all the winners, and a huge thanks to all the role takers and the guests. Now, we will be moving on to the session we all have been waiting for. And this session is a very important session when it comes to a club, a Toastmasters club. Let us all move on to the MOT session. First of all, what I'll do is, for the ones who do not know what MOT is, MOT stands for Moments of Truth. It's a session where we all take out time, understand and evaluate certain aspects of the club, and we basically rate ourselves out of 5. So this is what we do in an MOT. So I'll just drop the link in the chat. This is the link for the form. I request all of you to click on this link, open the form, and start filling up the form. Please take your time, read every important, every question, try to understand it and carefully evaluate and rate those points with respect to the way in which we have been doing our meetings or the way the club is functioning. We'll take 10 minutes to fill up this form, and after 10 minutes, we'll all get back and discuss the results of the form. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Preeti, for joining. It was really nice having you here.
Thank you very much, Aparajita. I'm very sorry for leaving in between, but I have a class to attend. All the very best, everyone. See you soon.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
What is it about? What is it about MOT?
MOT is Moments of Truth. It's when we evaluate ourselves. So in the form, if you see, we have a lot of questions. We answer those questions. And at the end, we will together evaluate the results.
Yeah, just to give a brief intro about what it is. So just like we have objectives for every speech, we have objectives for a club. and the way that a club performs. So the Moments of Truth captures how are we doing with respect to education, with respect to membership, with respect to public relations, with respect to administration. So there are different sections. If you go through one by one, you'll get a lot of, like she said already, you'll get a lot of questions to answer. And please try and answer them as honestly as possible so that, you know, the club led by Aparajita, the area led by Naveen, and the division led by me, we'll know exactly what is it that you members want from the club, and are we doing everything we can to make sure that your journey is as fruitful as possible, and that if we are doing anything wrong or maybe not to your expectations, we'll. So ideally, in the offline world, we used to have groups. We'll divide people into groups and ask them to fill out only specific sections. But since we are online, we opened up the form for everyone. So all of you will fill all the sections. In case you feel something is not relevant for you, you can give a neutral rating, which is 3. But otherwise, if you want to give 1, 2, or 4, 5, feel free to do so.
Also, if you have any doubts, you can ping me or Toastmaster Manvi. We can help you out with your questions.
Professionally arranged meeting room, actually it's virtual, no? How can you say that?
For that, you can just take note of the fact that if the meeting has been open on time, if the guests are welcome, if nobody has any problem in joining the meeting, you can consider those things.
Okay, fine.
It's asking for group names. No.
I'm sorry, Vishal.
It's asking for group names in the third group member names. Oh.
Is it a necessary question?
No.
Then don't answer it if it's asking for a group name.
The doubt is the question at the end of the form. What is the cause of disturbance and what is the return? Are we supposed to fill it now or after the discussion?
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. Could you please post your question in the chat?
Okay.
Yeah.
I have a doubt. There's one question, like all projects are manual projects. What is it about?
I'm sorry, all projects are?
Manual projects.
I'm not really very sure. Toastmaster Manvi, could you please answer that question?
Manual projects means.
DTM Akshay, you're on mute.
Okay.
It means pathways.
Yeah.
Whatever projects you're delivering, it has to be related to your pathway.
what can be done for the six? Is it compulsory to fill this form? Am I audible?
Yeah, you're audible. You can fill this
because form. There's a network issue here. That's why. Is it because I'm? Is it okay?
If your network is permitting and if you can fill the form, it will be great.
That's why it is buffering here. That's why.
Okay, we have time left. So if the network is normal after a few minutes, you can just continue filling up the form.
DTM Akshay, I have a doubt and a question. Toastmasters sponsoring new members recognized. What does this mean? DTM Akshay, are you there?
Hey, hi, sorry. What was the question?
Toastmasters sponsoring new members recognized. What does this mean?
Okay. So in the membership form, you would have seen this thing called sponsoring member. So it doesn't mean that you literally sponsor members. It just means that you have brought somebody to the club who has now become a member. So that person becomes a sponsoring member, and every five members that you supposedly sponsor, you are recognized by TI by a pin. So I'm not sure if MVJ does it yet, but we'll see when we get the results.
Okay.
Recording in progress.
If you have already filled the forms, please put up a yes in the chat so that I can have a count of how many are filled and how many are left. We'll just wait for another 1 minute and then we can proceed with the session. I believe everyone has filled up the form. Is there anyone who's still filling up the form? Please let me know. Okay. So I believe everybody's done. I would now share my screen and give the virtual stage over to Toastmaster Akshay to proceed with the session.
Hey all, good evening. Just give me a second. I'm just give me 1 second. All right, sorry. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, good. Sorry, I just reached home and I was booting up my laptop. Right, so what do we have? Okay, first of all, we have so many different club names. Folks, check out the dashboard. You will see the actual club name of MBJC Toastmasters Club. Never mind, just a small joke. But let's move on to the first section that we had, which is first impressions. Now, bear in mind, these are all your impressions. None of us had anything to do with it. And like I said in the beginning of the session, that this is what the members think about the club and its XCOM and up the ladder. So are the guests greeted warmly and introduced to officers and members? 50% of you, which means 6 people say strongly agree, which is good, which is a 5-pointer. 3 of you think that it's agree, which is 4 points, which is still good. Neutral are 4 people. So anyone would like to say why is it neutral? Now, bear in mind, when we do these rating sessions in even in our office, we usually prefer 4, 5, 1, and 2. because 4 and 5 are definitely positive signs, 1 and 2 are definitely negative signs, but 3, which is neutral, is a bit dicey. And why I say it's a bit dicey is because it never gives us an impression of whether it's good or bad. So we'd like to know what is the scene here. So anyone who said neutral, can you please let us know why is it neutral? If any of the neutral folks think that they don't know what to answer, then that's fine. But otherwise, please do let us know.
I put neutral mainly because it's often a toss-up whether we like greet the guests properly at the start. For example, mm-hmm. I've gone to other clubs and they're more friendly in a way at the start of the meeting than we are. We usually, oftentimes it's a silence at the start of the meeting. So I think that comes down a lot of the times to the fact that members join a little bit late or very close to the start time. So there is also that lack of opportunity to greet them at the start. So that's why I'm neutral.
Oh,
because I can't say it's good or bad. It's not sort of stuck in the middle.
Yeah, I was about to say the same actually. Because a lot of times what happens is when we talk about a professional environment, right? We often forget the warmness that is there in, you know, people. And I completely understand where you're coming from, Vishal. So point taken. I will make a note of it right away. Okay, anyone else would like to share anything else? I'm specifically talking to the 3 people who have given it a neutral. The red and blue folks are fine. And don't worry, it's not like if you give a bad impression, that means that we will, you know, come to your house and sort of threaten you. Not going to happen, don't worry. This is more to understand. Yeah, this I'm going.
Okay, so we do not agree on this one, but to build up on Vishal's point, I guess we treat guests warmly because at the end of the meeting we give them more time. But at the start we don't do that. So building up on Vishal's point, we do treat guests warmly is what I feel.
Okay. I think it's either my network which is patchy or it's yours, but what I understood is that what you're saying is we give people time at the end of the meeting to sort of socialize, but not at the beginning, which is what is probably the cause of this neutral reaction. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. I'll take that point. Okay, fine. Never mind. Point noted. I will definitely take it up with the area director and the club XCOM. Moving on to the next question. Give each guest a name tag. Okay, fine. I completely understand the yellow reaction here. In District 92, historically, we have never given a guest name tag ever. Not in any corporate club, not in any community club that I know of, definitely not in a college club, even in the offline times, because, we just don't do it. It's too much of a logistical headache. We definitely do give a name tag when we do meet in, let's say, Forte, TLI, Coronation, because each location has their own rules when bringing in guests. So for example, if we were to conduct a officers training program in SAP, SAP gives a name tag so that you can pin it on your shirt and, you know, people, the security knows that you're a guest. Second part, not so true, because we do have a guest book. In this case, guest book usually means a Google form, which I think the VP membership will circulate. I'm not sure if that is done yet. Aprajita, can you confirm?
Could you please tell what sort of form it is?
It's basically like a form which has your name, your email ID, your phone number, and any other details that you might need. In our company, we have this ID number, employee ID, which we capture, so that in the next meeting, we send the mail to all these folks as well who have attended as guests. So do we do that?
First of all, for the form, whenever we have a voting form, we have the name and WhatsApp number and the contact number in the form. So if there's any guest who votes, we have their contact details. And we have guest groups. We have three guest groups in WhatsApp. So all the meeting invites and everything is sent over there as well.
Okay. All right, fine. So we have a different way of doing things in MBJ, which is good, but at least we are capturing the names and the contact information of the guests that come in, right?
Yeah, and also the VP membership gets in touch with the guest. The VP membership usually sends a hi or like asks the guest their classes and the year they belong from. So that is done.
Okay, fine. Now that we are equipped with this knowledge, any of the neutral folks or the green folks or the violet folks, anyone would like to say anything? Probably something that we can do better. If you're silent, I will take it as a good, which means agree. But if not, then please do let us know what you think.
According to me, I think from the club side, we do everything to promote our meetings. Like I mentioned, we have WhatsApp groups, so we send invites there. We also send our meeting reports. So if you've seen our meeting reports, they are usually well made, very creatively made. So those are circulated. We also put up stories on Instagram and LinkedIn, and we also put up regular posts. So we have a very like constant social media presence. That is done. All the guests are also contacted. The VP membership does it. After the meeting, the VP membership gets in touch with the guest and gets on a call actually and tries to understand if that guest can be a potential member of our club or not. So all this is done. Yeah.
Okay. PTM Akshay, I have a feedback.
Yes, ma'am.
I think if we can implement the fact that you mentioned that after someone comes to a meeting, after a guest comes to the meeting,
mm-hmm.
we can send the future mail invites to them via mail or WhatsApp or something, so that we are in constant touch with that guest,
right,
who has once visited the meeting.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we can implement this.
Okay. Fine.
That point for in terms of guests, like MVJ guests, we put them into the group and send them invites, and potential members, I usually send them like a personal invite. As VPN.
No, I'm talking about all the guests that come to the meeting. Say some girl has come today, then you might want her to come again. So even if she's not a potential member, you can just send her the invite. Send it to all the guests who come to the meeting, be it from within the college or outside the college, so that they are aware of the club.
Yeah.
They are always aware of the club.
Sure. So regardless of, you know, whatever, I still put it as capturing details of guests for future meetings. And I think probably Aprajita, Manvi and Vishal and me, we'll probably take it up in the future. I think Vishal is a VP membership, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So in case there is some process that we are not doing that great, not an issue, we'll definitely take it up and maybe smoothen the process in the future. But if there is any other specific feedback with regards to the people who have voted in either yellow, green, or violet, please do let me know. Or, you know, let us know. In case you're not comfortable sharing the feedback right away, not an issue. You can share it with Aprajita personally, so that then we'll be able to take it up later. Okay, moving on. Professionally arranged meeting room. I think in the online setup, like I think Aprajita already clarified it earlier, it's pretty convenient and pretty easy. I think most of you are red and blue, so we are good there. Somebody said neutral. I think it's okay, guys. Mathematics question: what is 8.3% of 12? I think it should be 1 or 2, but
guess that's 1.
Yeah. Okay, never mind. I think we are anyway more than 50%, so we are good there. We'll move to the next one. Convenient meeting location. Cannot get any more convenient than this, which is basically, I was attending this meeting all this while on my phone. If you can see in the participants list, there are 2 of my name. So I just came back home and switched on to my laptop. So cannot get any more convenient than this. Somebody says neutral. Okay. I would like to know what is more convenient than this. But anyway, just a small joke. We can move forward. Guests are invited to address the club. Okay, there are more people saying no. Although technically, you know, more than 50% of you, or more than rather, almost 80% of you say it's a good thing that we do that. But somebody said disagree, and disagree is something that we need to discuss. So can someone, whoever has given the disagree, can they step forward and just let us know what are we doing maybe not right when we say guests are invited to address the club? All right, in the meantime, let me give you my impression. So even today, I think when both the there was one speaker and one evaluator who were from outside, both of them were asked to, you know, share their feedback and talk, and I think Aprajita did that really well. So I think that comes in this criteria of guests invited to address the club. Even I think in the beginning, I think when I joined, I was asked to say hi as a division director, although, you know. So if somebody disagrees, can you please tell us what is something that we are not doing? Okay, maybe you can ping Aprajita separately or Manvi separately and let them know what is it that you think was not really great here. But we'll move on in the meantime. Guests invited to join, 50% say agree, 33% say strongly agree, 1% neutral, 1% disagree. Or, you know, you can even ping me in the chat. I'll not take your name, I'll just read out a point. So we are 83.3% great here. So which means that the guests are invited to join the club, which is, I think, what the VPPR and the VP membership you know, strive to do, and because that's part of their role. So we are good here as well. So let's now move on to the textual feedback that any one of you might have given. Okay. What is the cause of the challenge? Okay, networking. I think it is one of the points that we saw earlier, which is meeting location, I think might have been. And as college students, we find it a little hard to network at the start of the meeting. Okay, correct. This is something that I think Vishal and Aitisam were talking about earlier. So point noted. We will see what we can do here. It's a bit difficult, guys, understand. We are living in online world, and I have not attended my own club's meeting in over 18 months physically. Although, you know, we have Teams meetings, but it's not the same feeling. I completely understand with all of, completely understand that, and completely agree with whoever has written this comment. We'll see how, you know, given the COVID situation in Bangalore, we'll see how much we can go to the hybrid model or the fully offline model. It'll take some time. It's not like because you've given us this feedback, it'll happen automatically. We also have to consider, you know, the situation that is outside. What does MBJ College as such think about the COVID situation? So definitely, I completely agree with this feedback, and I'm there with you. The guests aren't being aware of the meet, since the meeting post and credentials are being shared on the previous day and there's not so much time for it to get circulated. Okay. Point taken. I will note it down. Point for the VPPR and the VP education, probably, but please understand that it's very tough to get roll takers, especially in the online scenario. And this is not so much of a feedback for the VP PR and the VP education as it is for the members of the club. So if as members, you are proactive and you come up and say that, you know what, VP education, Mr. or Madam VP education, I want to give this speech. I want to take up this role. If you come up and be proactive by, let's say, Wednesday, then by Thursday, the poster can be revealed to the whole world. And then we'll still have Friday, Saturday, 2 days of good time, or even Thursday, half a day to publish it to the world, so that it's in advance, the poster is shared in advance. So definitely feedback for the VPPR, VP education, no doubts about that, but also for all the members, so that their job becomes easier, right? So if you feel that this is a feedback, maybe let's try and implement it as members first. And then if we still feel that this is something that the VPPR is not doing well, or the VP education is not doing well, then we will definitely take up with that. All right. Can I see a thumbs up for that? Can I see a commitment from all the members that they will be proactive in helping the club officers? Excellent. I see a lot of thumbs up. Great. We'll see over the next few months if this continues. If it does, then we'll definitely take it up. In the meantime, we can move on. Okay, we can create a WhatsApp group for guests, so that, all right. Abhrajit, you were mentioning something about WhatsApp group for guests, right?
Yeah, we have 3 WhatsApp groups for guests. One was for first years, one was for second, third, and fourth years, and we have one more group that was created at the starting when we were doing our pre-charter meetings. So we have 3.
Okay, so this point is already taken care of, right? Okay. Assign different officers to talk to guests and members before the meeting. For sure. It's a part of the VP membership's role talk to the guests and make them feel comfortable. VPPR and VP education as well. But we can definitely work on that. The roles, especially the TMOD, can be assigned a little early. Da-da-da. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Again, the point that I mentioned earlier. If the members are proactive, this issue will take care of itself. So definitely this will stay on record, no problems. So let's move on to the next section, which is membership orientation. Formal induction, including presentation of membership pins and manuals. Okay. We have 75% people who say agree or strongly agree, and 3 people who say neutral. Anyone feels anything different here? Neutral folks? Are we not doing any presentation ceremony sort of a thing? All right, let me explain what it means first, and then maybe Aprajita can speak on behalf of the club. So formal induction is basically when you accept a member, okay, accept a person into your membership from a guest. So let's say that today, I'm just taking an example, let's say, Manvi has become a member last week of the club, and then in the initial presidential address, maybe a president says that, yeah, we have a new person called Manvi who has become a member from a guest. Now, that might be considered as a formal induction. Induction ceremony also means that the VP education sets up separate calls with Manvi saying, now that you are a member, this is what Toastmasters has to offer. There is a proper PPT that we share in SAP, but if you don't have it, let me know, we will share it with you. Presentation of membership pin. Okay, we don't have a concept of membership pin because it needs to be bought from Toastmasters International and it's costly. So in US mostly they do this process of membership pin, but in District 92 we've never actually, even I don't have a membership pin, to be very honest. and I've been a Toastmaster for the past 6 years. Manuals, again, the wording of the question is a bit old. When we actually used to have the CCCL manuals, we used to have books, but nowadays it's all pathways, it's online. So as soon as you become a member, the base camp opens up for you, Toastmasters account opens up for you. So we don't really have a book giving ceremony sort of a thing. So now that we've understood the meaning, is there anything, or would the neutral folks like to change it to 4 or 5? Aparajita?
Okay, so for this, whenever a new member joins, we usually put up posters on Instagram to welcome the member. We also put up posters in our WhatsApp group, and everybody has a welcome message for the new member. And if the member comes to the meeting for the first time, we basically the president is supposed to address that, and the president is supposed to welcome. So Arthur joined us recently in this term, and on that day I was not available. So Toastmaster Shruti, who was the PO that day, she did it. And every time the member takes up a role for the first time, it's always encouraged. And the member is always invited at the end of the meeting to speak about how they felt about taking the role for the first time. So that is done. The member is also assigned a mentor from the starting. So whenever a member takes up the role for the first time, the mentor is assigned. And for the pathways on the Toastmaster website, Toastmaster Vishal takes care of it. So basically, he's responsible for checking if that person understands what is to be done on the website or not.
Okay, fine. Then we are good to go from my end. From all that you've said, I think we are set. So like I said, I keep repeating, if anyone has any specific feedback, please do ping your XCOM and we'll take it up with them later. So moving on. Assignment of mentor. I think we are great here. 100% of you are 4 or 5. So great shout out to the VP Education. I'm not sure who that is, but great job. We are good here.
Lavanya. No issue. The VP Education is Lavanya.
Lavanya. Great job, Lavanya. Good job done. Education programs and recognition system discussed. 83.4% of you say that we are good here. 16.7% say neutral. Two people. So if anyone feels that they are not aware of the education program and recognition system, education program is Pathways, which is where both of your speeches were given from today. One was, I think, L1, P2 and L2, P1, I think. So if you're not aware, please do ping Lavanya and discuss with her. Recognition system is the Distinguished Club program, which is what your XCOM would have filled and sent to your area director, Naveen. So once again, if you're not very familiar with that, please do ping either Aparajita or Lavanya and they will be able to help you out.
For the DCP points thing that we had to fill in the starting, I think it was the club success plan that you were mentioning, right?
Yeah.
So for the club success plan, me and my XCOM team, we discussed it together and we filled it. The club might not be actually aware of what the club success plan is all about, but the XCOM knows it very well.
Fair enough. But if any member feels that they need to understand what it means, you know, your member can always contact any one of your XCOM members and you can see what they have written on your behalf as a club in the document.
Yeah, and also if there's anyone who's interested in reading the CSP, I would share it with you. So if you want, you can ping me.
Yeah, definitely. Learning needs assessed. We have a good amount of people saying yes. More than 74%, 75%. If any member, once again, if any member feels that their learning needs are not assessed or the VP Education is not aware of what you want to do and why you're here. This is especially for the people who have voted in green, which is disagree, please do ping Lavanya separately, and you know, she will discuss it with the XCOM and the area director, and they will take care of it. But don't worry, today it is green. I can assure you, when we do this MOT again in February, March, it will not be, you know, in the one or two zone. It will definitely be in the 4 or 5. So I'll also make a note of it. Just give me a second. Got it. Speaking roles assigned. 83% of you say yes. There's one member who says no, but maybe they've written it in the feedback down below. So we'll take it up when we see that. Moving on. Member involved in all aspects of club activities. Okay, this is a slightly problematic zone because I see 50% of you say yes and 50% of you say no. Folks, anyone would like to pitch in about what is it that we are lacking in?
Okay, can I?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so what I have noticed is from the past few weeks, we have only a bunch full of members that take up the whole roles. For instance, Aparajita has been doing the role of evaluator law for, I think, third consecutive week. Last time it was, I was doing a role and, I was one of the tag team members and Aditya was general evaluator. Today he is the TMOD and I am the general evaluator. So the roles are changing, but the members are remaining the same. Like you are just juggling the roles among the same members. So that's where I guess problem is for members not getting involved. Like all of them are not getting involved.
Okay. All right. So there are two aspects to this problem. I mean, two sides of the problem. One is the VP membership, VP education not giving you a certain role that you want? And the second aspect of this particular problem is that you are not volunteering to take up a certain role, right? So is it the first part or the second part?
I feel it's definitely the second part, that the members need to take up the roles. But what I feel is there should be a interaction with the members as to why they are not taking up. Like I completely take it on the members that we are not volunteering ourselves, but for those members who are not volunteering, this is something, it's a request from me to the XCOM team as to have a chat with them as to why they are not taking it up, and if they have valid reasons, then well and good. Otherwise, they should take it up. That's what I feel.
Yeah, completely there with you, Ajisam. At least we got one thing clarified, that the VPAT is doing their job properly, which is giving opportunities to people to grow. So again, like I said before, this is something that the club, each club member needs to take it upon themselves. And I think there are 28 members as per the recent dashboard update that I've seen in FBGC. And out of that, 12 are present here, barring, you know, two accounts of my own. So maybe take it up amongst yourself, upon yourself, to make sure, because see guys, you are here for a reason, and that reason is not to please anyone or make anybody else happy. It's mainly to be happy yourself and to grow in your whatever you want to do. So if you are here, then make sure that you make full use of the opportunity that is given to you. I'm not saying that you should be there for all four meetings in a week. If you're there in all four meetings, great, nothing like it. But times are uncertain. There might be other things you might want to do. So if you are there at least for two meetings in a week, minimum of two meetings in a week, I think your whatever membership fees you're paying is completely redeemed. So maybe take it upon yourself as a challenge for the next three and a half months that we have left in the year, and see, is it really agreeing with you? The point that Aitasam mentioned, I completely take it up, and I will write it down as well, that the XCOM members can probably split responsibilities amongst themselves or sort of divide members amongst themselves, and they can probably talk to, let's say there are 7 XCOM members, so 28 people, 4 people, so 3 people, if everyone talks to, we will get the learning needs assessed right away. So just give me a second.
Akshay. In terms of learning needs of each of the members, we've done one-on-one sessions. I think more broadly speaking, the problem with members having to take up roles is that what I've noticed is that if you want to get like a value out of TM, you need to be here for 6 months, a year.
Definitely.
So members who haven't been that active per se or joined recently, it's hard to see that growth immediately, which is why they're not incentivized to take up smaller roles like tag team roles, like evaluator roles. They'll usually come to a speaker role because that's where they feel they get the most value. And then after that, like, they're not incentivized to go to cross club either or take up, you know, tag team roles more specifically.
Okay. Yeah, that's a very good point, Vishal, and that is something that we've been talking about since 2018, to be very honest, ever since Pathways, you know, came into the picture, because Pathways doesn't really, you know, like, to use your word, incentivize the tag team roles or a GE role or, you know, evaluator roles. So that is something that we've already taken up as an action item for district officers, and we are trying to tackle it the best way we can. There is something that is coming up in the month of November, December, which might help alleviate the problem. I'm not sure it will go. I'm not saying that it will go away definitely, but we are trying to incentivize it as much as we can from the division. So maybe watch out, you know, for that. But I agree with your point. And yeah, that's something that even I've discussed with even Rishabh, which is a district PQD. So this is not a problem that just the club, you know, your club member is facing. It's widespread, and we have taken it up with the district. As a matter of fact, I just had a chat with Rishabh last Saturday, and we'll definitely try to do something about it. So that action item I take up on myself as the division director. So.
For college clubs, also an added problem to the same point is that there are other college clubs that are, I don't know, more easily able to show potential members that they, you know, get something out of the club. I found it as VPM a little difficult to stack up Toastmasters value against other clubs' value.
I'm sorry, show what?
Like as VPM, it's been a little difficult to show the value of Toastmasters versus another club's value in the club, because none of the other college clubs are paid for one. So that's, and I know that other college clubs are able to clearly define what they do. In Toastmasters, it's a little difficult because when college students come, especially, first of all, they're broke. That's one problem, which I put in the feedback. The second problem was that it's hard to make them believe that they can come here and improve themselves. That's the main problem.
Vishal, I'm not entirely sure I understand what you mean. So probably what we're doing in the interest of time, Vishal, you can ping me personally, or we can have a call with Aprajita, and we'll try to understand what is the exact issue here. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Yeah. So Aprajita, give me a call, or, you know, we can talk to Vishal separately, and in case you need me or Naveen, just add us to the call. We'll take it up, because I think this is a very deep-rooted issue.
Yeah, and adding to the point of member involved in all aspects of club activities, I think the VP education and the VP education associate, they always reach out to people and they just ask people if they want to take up roles or not when there are a lot of roles that have not been filled yet. So it's a little hectic for them to, you know, go and ask people, do you want to take this up or are you interested in taking this up? Because people these days like have been a little less active is what I feel. And also another little issue that we have is members backing out. We have been facing this issue since I think past 2-3 weeks where members have said no at the last moment. Because everybody, most of the people are there in the meeting today, I would like to tell everyone that it becomes very difficult for us to, you know, manage speakers or find speakers or find role takers at the end. Role takers finding is not that big of a problem, but finding speakers is a very huge problem. Like it's very difficult to find speakers. And that too on a Sunday. Most of the people who are working, for them Sunday and Saturday are the only days they can chill. So it becomes a little difficult for them also to say yes. So it's just overall difficult. So I would like to suggest if you guys are not comfortable in giving a speech in a certain week, please decide it at least 2 or 3 days prior. If you have to give a speech, decide it at least 10 days before. Set yourself a deadline that, okay, the next Sunday, next to next Sunday, probably a certain Wednesday or Thursday, you can decide that, okay, next to next Sunday, I'll give my speech. Prepare your speech well in advance. And still, if you think if you have a lot of work to be done on the speech, please let us know by at least Thursday. Because then Friday and Saturday are the 2 days where we can find speakers. Sunday or Saturday, if there's someone who says that we can't give a speech, taking time out of our schedules that we've already planned for Saturday and Sunday, going and finding speakers, texting everyone around in various groups, it just becomes a little difficult. So if you have taken a role, I would request all of you to please stick to it and not back out as much as possible and make our work a little easier.
Yeah, I completely agree with Tabrajana. And in case you are not, you know, free on any of the Sundays, you can definitely talk to Naveen and he will be able to find a replacement club for you all. So that maybe if you're not free on Sundays, because let's be honest that after the month of Shravan, we have a lot of festivals. And this year, unfortunately, a lot of festivals have come on weekends. Something that we also really regret because we don't get holidays, but never mind. So in case you're not free on weekends, you can ping Naveen. You can get a slot in one of the weekday clubs, which is mostly corporate clubs meet on weekdays. So then you can continue your journey, you know, maybe not on Sunday, but on a different day. But that's a different conversation altogether. We'll come to that when we go down. But I understand and I listen. I've listened to all of you. Great points. I'm trying to manage college and TM, it becomes difficult to go over each utility. Okay, I think this is what probably Vishal was saying earlier. Okay, that's a difficult one. I'll think about it definitely. I'll talk to Naveen and Prajit about it. What can be done to address it? Have an officer to do a small induction program. Okay, isn't this done by the VPA?
VPI do for the new member or VPM. Because when they join, I'll tell them, come on a call.
So you're already doing it, right?
Haha, yeah.
Okay, perhaps the person who said it is probably not aware of that, but never mind. Vishal is already doing his as part of his VP membership role. So in case you haven't had it, maybe just ping him separately. Moving on quickly, fellowship and fellowship writing communication. We have guests greeted warmly and made welcome. I think we are good here. More than 92.7%, 91.7, sorry. Enjoyable education meeting plan, 100%. Great, excellent. Really happy to see that. Regularly scheduled social, okay, yeah. Something that I've been mentioning for the past 1 year when I was area director last year as well. I am probably the one person who's really sad about this particular point that we're not able to do. But unfortunate situations. We cannot really do anything about it. We cannot, although I think your XCOM has made a wonderful decision to probably have a lunch in Beer Garden a couple of weeks back, I think. And that's something that, you know, we've never had. I've never met any of my last year's presidents or even this year's area directors. My team as such has never met for any event, but I think your club did it and that was great. So I hear you. Regularly is the keyword here, not happening. Nothing that I can, anyone can do about it. So, but we understand the pain that you're feeling. Members participate in area, district, and international events. All right. We do have contests coming up starting next month after the DCM on 25th. And after that, whoever wins in your club as a contestant will go up to the area. If your club member wins the area, they will go to the division and district and so on. So watch out for that. If we still feel that we need participation, we will definitely pick it up. We'll need contest role takers for the division contest. We need contest role takers for the area contest. So please do nominate yourself and we'll take it forward from there. Interclub events encouraged. We are good here. 83.3% say yes. Maybe 16.7% people don't know that there are interclub events that happen. In case you don't have, you haven't had a linkers meeting yet, maybe talk to your talk to the clubs in your area and see how you can have a linkers meeting. There are also awards for linkers meetings, so you can take it forward from there. Next one, club newsletter website published regularly. I think there was one newsletter that was published earlier this year, right? So we are good here also. I'm pretty sure the VPPR is on top of it. If the VPPR is not, please do contact your ex-VPPR and they'll be able to guide you with respect to the newsletter publishing. We don't really have an MVJC TMC website, but which is fine, but we do have a lot of social media presence. I do see a lot of updates and posts that are shared on Instagram and stuff. So I think we are good here. Yeah, exactly what I was saying, pandemic and yeah. We need to figure out how to do the social events once we sort of get out of this whole work from home scenario. Regular unofficial meetings, maybe once a month, maybe. I wouldn't recommend it at this point because from the district and even from Toastmasters, we've got information that let's conduct online meetings until it's possible. In the US and in Europe, they've already started having offline meetings, but that's because the cases and the situation is much different there than it is here. So I will not ask you to meet regularly, you know, because that's not what has been told to us. So yeah, unfortunate situations, like I said. Moving on.
We can maybe start having offline meetings once or twice a month if the college resumes offline, in offline mode.
Yes, but that completely, yeah, that is completely the responsibility of the XCOM whether or not to do it. Program and agenda publicized in advance. 93% of you say it's good. So we are good here. I get where that one green is coming from. And that's, again, like I said, as long as the members are proactive, which by the way, until now you have been, so shouldn't be a problem in the long term. Members know program responsibilities and prepare to carry out all assignments. Okay, the one person who has said disagree, please do contact Lavanya, who's your VP education, or Aprajita, who's your president. In case you're not sure of how to handle a particular role, I'm sure you've been assigned mentors. So in case not Lavanya, then, you know, contact your mentor. They will be definitely able to help you out and guide you with your particular role. So I assume that the mentors have been assigned.
Yeah, mentors have been assigned for everyone. As soon as they join a club, we assign a mentor.
Okay, great. Then we are good here. So contact your mentors, or if your mentors are not that responsive, maybe you can contact your VP education. All projects are manual projects. Okay, the person who says neutral, manual projects means pathways. And in case you've seen any project which is given, which has been given apart from pathways, let us know. Pretty sure all of them are pathways. So we are good here. Meetings begin and end on time. Okay, today that's on me. You can blame me. You can send hate messages to me today because I am taking a lot of time for this MOT session. But usually, I believe the meetings end on time.
As for the starting, we usually start a minute or two late. That is usually because the role takers don't join on time. But that's just 1 or 2 minutes. So sometimes 1 or 2 minutes is fine. For ending, I think apart from this meeting, the past two meetings, we have been able to end on time before 7:30 or exactly at 7:30. So that is fine. Before that, we used to overshoot a lot. Like we did our meetings until 7:40 or at least 7:35. So we overshot earlier, but these days I think it's been under control, I believe.
Okay, fine, fair enough. So let's do one thing. Let's monitor the meeting timings for the next month, maybe 6 weeks, and then we'll take a call whether it's actually becoming an issue or if we're able to finish it on time. Does that sound good? Can I get a thumbs up?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Creative table topics and activities. I think we are good here. Not an issue at all. So moving on. Positive and helpful evaluations. Definitely. I think most of you agree with the point here, which is probably 85%. So we are good. In case anyone is not sure, once again, contact your VPA. They'll take it up with me. Moving on, network issues, time management issues for sure. Well, not all members attend the meeting. Okay, we've already covered this. Okay. Cut down on intro times. Okay, yeah, that is a valid point. We have even told it to the master of ceremonies who attended the TLIs that please do keep your intro short so that everybody can, you know, make effective use of their time. Fair enough, point noted. That's actually a very interesting point. Actually, give roles to people who don't attend meetings, which is something that even I'm trying to bring in this year. So I'll take that up. Club has 20 or more members. If anyone has any doubts about this, please do check out the dashboard. You will see that the club has 28 members as of today. So the 8.3 and 8.3, so 16.6% people who say that it's a disagree. I'd beg to differ. We have 20 or more members, so we are great. I will...
To comment on that, we've already finished our renewals. So we had set a renewal, like we had asked all the members who were willing to continue to pay by 16th or 17th because we wanted to clear out that and then do the MOT. So out of 28, 18 members I believe have renewed, and we lost 10 members. So I think this point is not valid as of now.
Yeah, 18 by 28 is 64%, which is really great because we still have 11 days to go for the membership renewal cycle to end. So I think we're good. And in case anybody has any doubts, please do check out the dashboard link that I've sent. You'd see the status of the club in terms of numbers. Members are retained. Okay, that is something that I will definitely not, you know, make a point to the VP membership or the XCOM. This is each member's responsibility that members are retained. We always talk about a lot of things that other people should do, but it's always also something that we must do. And that's something that we always forget. When you talk about your rights in a country like India, you always forget about the duties that come with being an Indian. right? And that is the same logic that applies to the club. If you think that your XCOM is not doing something right, definitely bring it up. That is your right as a member. But it is also your duty as a member to do a couple of things. And one of this is retention. So if you haven't renewed until now, if you're not one of the 18, please do renew your membership before the 30th of this month. We still have 11 more days. Now it's very simple. It's all like a Google Pay transfer that you have to do. Takes probably less than 30 seconds. So yeah. But I still think we are 66%, 67% good there. And if you're one of the green or the yellow folks, please do make sure that you've renewed your membership before, you know, anything else. Promotion of club in the community or within its organization. I, for one, can speak about the promotion that is done. I see MVJC's stories very often in my Instagram feed and also posts. But if there is anything in particular you think that we are not doing as a club, you know, please bring it up with your VPPR. Maybe they can rectify that mistake or rectify whatever we are not doing correctly. The program is varied and exciting. I think we are split three ways here. Four responses per. So I'd like to take a moment here and ask the folks present, why neutral? I mean, red and blue are fine. Anyone wants to talk about the neutral? Okay, never mind. Ping your XCOM separately and we'll take it up later.
Yeah, and also please let us know what we can do for you to make the sessions and the meetings more exciting and fun. Please ping in your ideas. Please ping in any theme that you want to have for the coming meeting. We can surely take it up and work on that. Yeah. So if there's anything fun that comes to your mind, please tell us. It really helps us. It'll really help us to make the meetings more amazing.
Yeah, definitely. Toastmasters sponsoring new members recognized. Okay, maybe we are not doing this as much as we should. Vishal, for all the new members that you've onboarded recently, have you filled in this field called, I think it's called sponsoring member or something like that?
Well, we've only onboarded one person this site, I mean, since this XCOM took up. And Well, we've only onboarded one person since we took up. From my memory, I don't remember filling out a form. I just did a small induction and took some details down, but I did not fill any form.
I started the new member. I did the registration. There was the sponsoring checkbox. I did not fill it because I didn't think that the member was sponsored. Could you also please explain what exactly sponsoring new members means?
Yeah, okay. So sponsoring does not mean, you know, sponsoring financially in this case. It means probably, let's say that Vishal is a friend of mine and I am a member of this club and I brought Vishal to this club. So he has come by my reference. So I can, when we fill the form for Vishal, the membership form for him, we can put him, we can put my name as a sponsoring name for him. So for every 5 members that I bring into this club, Toastmasters gives me a separate pin. So that's all about it. It's not very compulsory, firstly, and it's not very important as well. But a sponsoring definitely here does not mean membership fees. If you want to, you can do it. Nobody's stopping you from doing that, but it does not mean that.
Okay. I guess in that case, the members of the club do reach out to their friends or sponsor in this case.
Yeah. So whoever comes in, probably Vishal, what we can do is from the next member on, we can ask them because of whom did you come? And then we can put there.
Okay.
Yeah. Great. Regular membership building programs. Okay. Not really great. Okay. What are we not doing here? Because as I'm not sure if you know, but since August 1st till September 30th, we have this Smedley's Award, which is a membership related award given by Toastmasters International. There are three of them, August, September, February, March, and May and June. August, September is called Smedley's Award. February, March is called Talk of Toastmasters Award. And May and June is called the Beat the Clock Award. So there are three membership awards, and those can be considered in terms of your membership building programs, to have membership building programs. So you can have open houses during that time. You can have different things to boost up your membership. So are we not doing any of that here?
The plans we had for membership building particularly, we didn't do during the Smedley Award cycle, because a lot of potential members we could gain would be from the new batch of students that come into MBJ. So, and they come in October. So any efforts we've put into membership drives would have yielded results before the Smedley Award cycle. There was no real value in doing the Smedley cycle, like doing something extra for gaining memberships during like the Smedley program.
And to add on to that, also during like since we started and since the Medley's Award started in August, all of us had a lot of like, we had internals, I believe, and the juniors had exams. So everybody was occupied in one way or the other. And in the month of September, also a lot of people are like occupied. So we just thought we shouldn't go for this Medley's Award and push ourselves. Although for the membership building programs, we have a membership drive coming next week. It's a marathon, and we have five days and five departments, and these are the departments we are trying to target. From which departments we don't have members. So we are basically targeting civil, mechanical, we have chemical, electrical, and aerospace aeronautical. So we have invited one speaker per department, and we have scheduled a one-hour session that will be happening from next week. And when this is done, I hope we gain some potential members. We gain some members. And after that, when the new batch joins, we are planning of conducting an open house. And once we get the dates as to when we will have our induction and everything, we'll start planning it out.
Okay, sure, no problem. Fine, I'll convey this to your AD as well, so that he can follow up with Aprajita and with Vishal. We'll take care of this. So definite point noted. I've already jotted it down in my notepad. So yeah. Okay, college money. Yeah, I feel you. Problem for us all. Money is a very big problem. I mean, I completely understand. And by the way, if this money is for the sponsoring thing, I think you're clear with that. It's not membership fee sponsoring. Yeah. We need to find a way to optimize the incentives of TM. Okay, Aprajita, can you copy this statement and send it to me later? Because I really like the frame of this sentence. I'll take it forward with that. Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, achievement recognition. Last section, award applications submitted to WHQ immediately. In case you're not aware, all your levels that you complete, level one, level two, level three, are all submitted via Basecamp by your Basecamp managers. Basecamp managers include president, VP, and secretary. If they're not doing it, we'll talk about it. And the award submission actually happens via Club Central. So your VP education usually does it. I'm not sure if there is anybody else who has been given the, because all seven officers have access to Club Central. Anybody can file it, but traditionally VP does it. In case you're not aware, this is how the process is followed. But is there any change to that?
We only have president and VP VP membership who can do it. VP education and president. I'm not sure if the secretary can also do it. But for the award applications, a lot of people, they don't update it on this website. So that's why I can't. And also for applying for award, once you complete a level, you need to click on that. I think there's this button which is there for approval, I think.
Yes, yes. So for example, if you have, let's say, consider level one as mandatory three projects, which have four speeches, because L2S2. So once you complete all three projects, there is a fourth button that is enabled at the bottom. And you have to, this is for members, by the way, you have to click on it mandatorily, because if you don't, then it is not, the workflow doesn't pass it on to the Basecamp managers, and the Basecamp managers will not be able to approve it from their dashboard. So members, please note, at the end of every level, please do enable and click that button. It says mark for completion. Please do it so that the Basecamp manager, which is president, VP and secretary, they get access to your project so that they can take it forward later. But apart from that, I think if we are not doing something specifically, we'll take it up. Progress start displayed and maintained. Okay. Yeah, something that we used to follow in the offline mode, but I'm still glad that 67% of you say it's good, but yeah, I understand the thought process that you're coming from. It's very difficult to sort of maintain and display, but maybe once in a month, what we can do is we can probably show a graph of like how many people have gone through their levels.
For the progress thing, Lavanya?
Yeah. So the thing is, we've maintained what level each person's reached and how much they've completed. But the thing is, I think it was shared once in the previous XCOM. I haven't shared it yet. I should probably do that once after this is over. But yes, that chart is still being maintained with respect to level completions.
Yeah, and in any case, if anyone of you has doubts, you can reach out to Lavanya. If she already has some Excel sheets, you can show it to you. But I'm sure that the XCOM is on top of it.
Yes, we can do that.
Member achievements formally recognized with ceremony. Are we doing that? I'm not sure because I've not seen it.
We do not do it in the meeting. However, we put the posters on social media and our WhatsApp groups. Where if someone comes level, or for the TMOM as well, we also send out gifts to TMOM and we just put up posters and everything.
Oh, fair enough. So we are good there. In case anyone of you would like to share it in the meeting, please do let Lavanya know so that she can share it once, probably, you know, once in 2 weeks or once a month. Club district and international leaders recognized. I can personally vouch for that because every time I've attended MBJ's meeting, even though it's not mandatory, they do recognize me as the division director. Every time Naveen attends, I've seen him also being recognized as the area director. So from a district leader perspective, I think we are good. Club and member achievements publicized. We are very good there. Almost 90% of you say yes. DCP is used for planning and recognition. Guys, if you don't know what DCP is, please do check with Aprajita, Manvi or Lavanya. They know about it. And trust me, DCP is one of the best tools that we use to track how the club is doing. In case you're not very sure, I've already posted a link in the chat for the dashboard. So I also check not with Aprajita directly, but I check with her through Naveen how the club is doing, and DCP is definitely being used for planning. So from a division director standpoint, we are good there. Nil, great. Thank you so much, all of you, for taking part in this Moments of Truth session. We got really good updates, and I've noted down 7 points about different things with regards to education, membership and public relations and also administration. And I will pass on this feedback to your area director, Naveen, and we will work together to make sure that this feedback doesn't come back again. Maybe we'll get new feedback next time, which is good, which means that the club members are really thinking about what they're doing and how the club is performing. But we'll make sure that this particular feedback doesn't come back again, and we'll work on it to make sure that this is improved. That is something that I can promise you as a division director. And we will see you in the next MOT session, which will happen sometime in the months of February and March. So give us some time. We'll definitely work on this. With that, I hand the stage back to your president, Aprajita.
First of all, thank you so much, Toastmaster Akshay, for taking up this role at the last moment, because Toastmaster Naveen was supposed to do it, but then he was really busy and then you came. So thank you so much. And thanks to everyone who attended an extra half an hour. And thanks for giving your time to the club, and all your valuable inputs will be taken into consideration. And we'll have a discussion as to how we can improve the club and the functioning of the club. And if you guys have any suggestions, please let me know. Do not feel shy to give a feedback which you think is on the negative side, but please give it as a form of the feedback. That will really help us to make the club even better, and it will really help us to understand where we are lacking. And with this, we come to the end of our 52nd chartered meeting. Thank you so much, guys, for attending. I shall now stop the recording.